We started in the streets. We didn't have any money to buy footballs, so we started with tennis balls. You'd always have a tennis ball in your pocket. We developed some means, some strategies to make it more interesting. You take a tennis ball, you take a piece of string, put it into the tennis ball, keep it so you can always play around, even as you talk to people. And as kids, you start up that way. You play barefooted. Then it got to the point where you would say one street boys, maybe four kids from one, challenge four kids from the other street. You play and maybe like 10 cents or 15 cents, the winners.
He is known by the name Kalamazoo.
The first game I played for South Africa was at Curry's Fountain in Durban, at the Curry's Fountain Stadium. And we played what was then called Belgium Congo, which is now the Congo, but at that time it was still ruled by the Belgians, so it was called Belgium Congo. And I happened to play a very, very good game. I scored two goals in that game. And the first goal was just a tremendous goal that I worked on my own, coming up from the wing.
He was the first black African player to play professional soccer in Europe.
There was no black person I could talk to, or even a color, or just somebody that looked like me, or somebody I had confidence in. These were all new people, white people I'd never associated with. This is my first time. So how do you deal with it? We went training, and after training, we had a bath about half the size of this. So after training, you all go into the bath. With all those white people naked, I'm naked and they're naked. It's my first time. They sort of sit to the side and I sit to the side, and I'm thinking things, but I can't say it, you know. We come out, they take their towels and they try to say the wipe, and I do the same to me. And then they go to the lounge to go and eat. I go to the go and lounge to eat, and I sit alone at the table. You know, nobody's coming to sit with me.
His achievement is overwhelming. From playing for Coventry Football Club in England to signing for European giant Barcelona and Olympic Marseille in France.
I went to Holland. I was in Amsterdam Heracles. And that's where I found they played the type of football that I like, possession football. We won the league the first time with my first year there, when I was there. I was voted the best player. I had the opportunity to get invited to meet Queen Juliana and Prince Bernard in Soestdijk, Barcelona, and in Valencia were very interested in me. I said, okay. So I signed some papers. So they loaned me to Marseille in France. So I was in Marseille for about 3-4 months. Torino got hold of Otto Gloria and in Barcelona, and asked, could Otto Gloria come and help them rebuild Torino? So I was then in Marseille. So Otto Gloria and Barcelona then talked to the Torino people, and they bought my contract from Barcelona. So instead of, I was in the south of France in Marseille. So I just went up, Nice, Monte Carlo, right into Torino. That stayed Torino until I got here. In Torino, there were two teams. Juventus, which was owned by the Fiat Motor Company. And Torino, which we called ourselves the people's team. We had more supporters than Juventus, of course, it's always that. But Juventus had all of the money. I still hold the record, scored 5 goals in one game against Verona.
Not only has he been acknowledged as a legend and ambassador in South Africa, he has also had a street in Amsterdam named after him.
I was awarded the Order of Inkermang in Gold, which is the highest civilian honor given to a man of the country. I've been inducted into the Hall of Fame. I'm listed on South African legends. Just now that the office of the mayor of Pretoria has been calling me, they want to name a street after me in Pretoria. They're just realizing that now, but I've had more honors from outside the country. You know, I have a street named after me in Amsterdam. You know, I have on the who's of legends in Holland. I'm on that on the internet. I've had this movie made of my life story. I have a big book publishing company that have named their auditorium in my favor. So here in New Jersey, in Orange, the mayor there have given me the key to the city of Orange. So I've had a lot of more outside than I have inside, of course, because of apartheid. And a lot of the people I've grown up have died out. So you get younger people who come in who just hear about you. I had a program, the Kalamazoo South African Foundation for Education Through Sport, where I gave out scholarships for kids, boys who could play football and be able to make it into play for a school team here. They should be able to make the grade. They should pass at least with a C grade, English, science and math. There were two things in my life that I never thought I'd see in my lifetime. First, it was freedom and independence in South Africa. That just blew my mind. The second, that we could stage the World Cup. That also blew my mind.